and visit this artist again. Do you make a good living from this?
I survive. I wouldn't say I make a good living. Very few potters make a good living. But we have a lifestyle that is probably a lot more satisfying than many people, because you're creating things, and that's important. You know, if you're creating things that people appreciate and love to use, then that's satisfying. It's not about making money, it's just about having enough. And I also teach, so I try and pass my knowledge on to younger students.
From an old fence.
Okay.
This is for the firewood?
Yep. Kiln.
Hello. Okay.
You guys don't mind being photographed?
Oh, my big fat ass. No. Try not to get too.
This is Daniel. This is...
Hi, Daniel.
Hi. Ellie. Nice.
Sorry, my head can't swivel that far. Come let me see Helena. You. Hello, Jeff. Hi. How are you?
This is Helena and this is Sammy.
Come over here so I can actually see you. Hello, how are you?
What? Beautiful.
Oh, no.
Already there.
How thin can you go? I think is the...
Until it goes...
Exactly.
Daniel came around the other day and met Alice there, so he's come back here and he's got a bit of a program which goes all over the world. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so yeah.
What kind of a program?
If I'd known, I would have put my face on.
I'll give you the YouTube channel afterwards. It's rather mind-blowing.
Oh, cool.
And makes violins.
Does
he? Oh, see. Fingertips. Is everything when you're throwing.
Yeah.
There was a young girl, she must have been 18, at the community center. She played the violin. She threw one pot brilliantly her first time and then every time. It was just all of the, it's all in the fingertips and being conscious of that.
Which community center?
Fern Tree Gully Community Arts Center. I started there about 20 years ago.
What happened?
Oh, I got too thin in one bit and it didn't like it, so yeah, back to the drawing board.
Through the mistakes, we learn what it's going to
cause. The wool got too thin in one spot.
So to get that shape, you've got to go over to the other side. Yes, so that's good.
That's my first one.
Wow.
Ever.
Really?
Off the hump.
Yeah.
That's my first one.
Yeah.
You will be on YouTube and forever for the whole world to see.
Breathe.
Very nice, Alan. Very nice.
I
fun. It's very relaxing.
Sometimes.
It's my best drug of choice. Love to sniff the old porcelain.
Ooh, that sounded really bad.
The old place. At least you didn't say the white dust.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah. What's the white dust?
Porcelain.
Yeah. Silicon?
It's clean mud.
Clean mud, absolutely.
Clean mud.
It's funny when the kids visit my window at the warehouse, and I'm sitting there throwing in the window, and I throw clay at the window, and then they come in, and then they feel the clay.
Yeah.
And then the parents go, oh, it's much softer than what I thought.
In the time.
Thank goodness.
I was talking to Jeff the other day, and he said that you probably would go to the island sometime again.
Oh yes.
When?
Well, I'm thinking about whether I'll go next year or not.
Next year?
Yes, possibly. When I go, it's always in the winter, because that's the best season for going out.
The winter in Australia?
Yes, yes, the winter in Australia.
That will be like a June, July or something?
Yes, that's the safest time to go. You don't get big hurricanes. The weather's much better. And it's not so hot.
Yeah. So I would like, if before you go, could you contact me?
Yes, yes,
so I will find how I can fly there.
Oh, yes, yes.
Maybe I will meet you there to make some documentary. That would be very interesting.
All right, yes, well, they're beautiful people. Now, these are a copy of a piece that I made after the Black Saturday fires. And I put a black glaze on the outside. And a lovely green glaze on the inside. But I've got to get another tool to finish off now.
So is that the one that you saw on Sunday?
Yes, yes. And she wanted one soon. I've got to put the swirls up it. Can I borrow your little wooden spatula?
I notice probably as I see a mosquito on your head.
That's okay.
But you cannot kill it.
That's
can I help you?
You can certainly have it. Ah!
Wow.
Now I've been decorated.
Okay.
There we are. See, that's got that swirl back in it. I can just take it off. There's the repeat of that vase that you like.
I was saving you from the
That's
right.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
The area that I go to is renowned for malaria,
is it?
But during the winter, no problem. So usually when you go out there, they recommend you to. It's okay to touch. You take your type, get your typhoid and your cholera and all the rest of it, but it's a pretty clean area. You're not going into the interior much, and there's a nice breeze on the coast.
Do you think that would be nice if
that would come? Oh, he would enjoy himself a great deal. Yes.
I can bring a violin.
Oh,
yeah, you know, the local people maybe have a violin.
They would love a violin because they're very musical people.
Mm.
They would love a violin. Absolutely.
My dad made a violin.
Yeah, oh, really?
Yeah, and a viola.
Oh, viola.
Yes.
Oh.
And she played the mandolin as well.
Okay.
My dad didn't play, he just made it.
He made them.
Yes, now there's one of the yachts that goes out there, the Suns.
Huh?
How many did he make?
He just made the one viola, one violin and one cello.
You still got it?
Mum's got the violin and the viola.
Because Daniel's a violin maker as well as a violin player. Equally as good.
Yeah.
But if you want, I'm saying tomorrow he's going to look at some of my fiddles and other friends, a couple of friends coming around to show and say, well, what do you think? And he'll say, well, it needs an adjustment of the sound post or this or that. He's going to give his appraisal.
Oh,
so if you're around tomorrow, bring up your...
See, that, Daniel,
that's not
this is something that I had made to help people who have trouble getting things off the wheel.
Mm-hmm.
It's what they call a pot lifter. It's been made in plastic.
Mm-hmm.
And I can put this around the pot,
mm-hmm.
and just give it a quick squeeze and lift one edge. It should just, there we are, it's got it. And I can lift this whole thing up and move it very successfully.
That's yours?
Yes. Yeah, it's not my invention.
Ah.
The original ones they used to make in metal. This is my sort of version of it. Now this was the first prototype. Yes, but I'll show you the way it ended up, because we improved it along the way, the final prototype, and it works beautifully. Accumulated stuff in the bucket in here.
All right.
So it's all going to get drier. Now, you've got to learn to be fast.
not
taking there on each one.
But it's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
It is.
You're doing a great job there.
Thank you.
And see all this here?
Yes, that's coming
off. That's all excess clay that you can take away.
Yep.
from there. Because then I'll turn it after. Cool.
No, you don't need to so much. You can come in here.
Depends on what sort of foot you want it on.
Exactly. So that cleans it up a lot more. You can still turn it.
Yes.
But that takes away the excess. It means it gives you a bevel and you can take it off a lot more.
Yeah. Looks very elegant. More diagonal. Yes, I was kind of going for the old... wide.
Oh, well, you could still do that with your turning.
Okay.
Just means
you still have enough room.
There's plenty of room there. It just means that this is an easier way to get it off the wheel.
Yes.
Once that too bad.
All right, where's his white lifter?
Yeah, this is what I'm thinking
about.
Can you
move to? Yep. I got to get up first. I got to get the hip engaged.
I think that's too small for the...
Now, see, I'll dry that section there. I start off with just the sending. So I do this at least three times just to get those clay particles working well.
Playing together.
Yes. That's getting better. Now come down and I'll stop. So there's a little bit of distance.
Yes.
Now you see I don't use very much water.
Slip that I find really lovely to work with.
Now I'll lift up the side. See here I'm sort of working sort of a little bit, but the position on the wheel that I'm using is probably 11 o'clock in some ways, not round here.
Yeah.
But I'm just using that to lift. And again, always reuse the slip on your hands because that's the best lubrication. You don't make the clay wet. And again, that's right. See, I get in and bring that thickness up.
It's your experience and your technique that allows you to go a little bit faster. I'm still
very much
at the novice stage.
Well, see, I'll shut a lot of this off at this stage.
Yeah.
But from here,
yes,
I can introduce this. Again, a little bit of slip on the tool itself. Bring it in. And I'm compressing the base with this as well.
Do you need a tea break, Simon? Your hips, your stretch? It does such a fantastic job.
Oh, she hasn't got the end of her clay yet. She's not allowed to get off.
Such a taskmaster!
I know, that's all right. No,
now, see, at this stage I'll take that excess away.
Yes. Is it? oddly enough, that makes my part go off kilter if I trim too much on the foot.
It's nice and sharp. It's the technique that you use to come in on.
Okay.
Oop, now I bumped it, but that's all right. We can easily fix something like that. And again, I can refine that shape now that I've taken the excess away from the base. Now, I'm not too worried about the outside surface in that I know I'm going to go over this afterwards and turn the outside surface. So I don't concentrate too much time on the outside. Okay. It's the inside that's important. And then we bring this up. And as you squeeze it in, it gets a little thicker.
Yes.
So it allows me to actually lift it up a little bit further.
More and more I'm finding my left hand has always got contact with my right hand.
Yes, you keep them so that they're fairly similar. Now,
I mean, just contact.
All right.
They've always
now,
somewhere.
See, very slight unevenness at the top. So, well, when you think where you've come from.
Yeah, exactly.
This is where this is useful. You always, from the inside out, I push out against my finger, and then it'll just lift off.
Yep.
And it's gone. And this is also used to smooth the inside and push against that so you get a lovely smooth interior, because these vessels traditionally were used for pouring, mm-hmm. so you want a beautiful smooth interior.
Yeah.
And it's a lot like a Japanese kimono too. You know, you always finish off the areas that you can't see as much as you finish off the areas that you can see.
Yes.
Now, Sammy just passes me over the little chamois.
Yeah, I didn't.
That's it, the chamois. That's it. It's alright. There's a little bit of deer skin. And this is used just to finish off the rim at the top. You get a lovely smooth rim.
I can see that machine up.
And if I want to refine that outside shape a little bit, I can just use this.
It's like a samurai sword there, Mr. White.
Yes, there we go. See, we've just refined it slightly. And I'll make sure that it's nice and clean down the base. It's actually pretty good there. And to take it off the wheel, straight through, no water, dry your fingertips. Now if you lift from one edge, just break that seal slightly. See, the seal's broken?
Yep.
Then you come right around the edge and just lift it, and it's off. And you have a bubble. And then bang, you can go straight over the next lump of clay and do the same. And in this case, because it's different clay, I'll clean that off. And with that amount of clay, you should be able to produce another one.
Okay.
Go for it.
I will go for it. Thank you.
Alfred, you always check the wind.
So how long have you been here with Mr. White?
I have known Mr. White maybe 4 years? Five years?
He hasn't been coming here.
So you find him a good teacher?
I would say he is not just good, but he is meticulous as well as comforting, because you don't usually get a master potter that is able to convey what you you need to know. And challenging, which is great. Because that's what we want. We don't just want somebody, a yes person, or somebody says, you know, that'll do.
You are here the longest.
Yes.
How long?
13 and a half years.
Do you have lessons to learn?
Always. Always. Uh-huh. Always loads to learn.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, just a little bit. He's a awesome teacher.
Yes. He's a great teacher.
Specifically, particularly anything.
His skill level is so varied, mm-hmm. and you know, you can do lots of different techniques. So from mold making to throwing off the hump, making tools, you know, and he's an amazing thrower, like beautiful, beautiful work. Mm. So, and doing wood firing, I love the wood firing. Wood firing is great fun. And working in the porcelain as well, you know, just, and the detail of the decorations. There's so much to learn. It's an ongoing thing.
So how is he as a person?
He's lovely. He's just a lovely man.
Very giving. There's so many potters that just give. Like, just they give their time, their expertise. That one little thing is that then you go, that's a great idea. Why can't I didn't think of that? And that's perpetuates that.
It's very, it's very giving in ideas and skill, passing on the knowledge.
He is
a true artist, definitely. So it's your first time back since
then? No, second time. The first time was 30 years ago.
Yeah.
I met Jeff on the train.
Oh, really?
The train stopped, and some kids asked me, what is the case inside my case?
Yeah.
I said, it's a violin, because the train did not move. They said, kids, it's okay, just play something.
Oh.
And just start playing violin on the train.
Yeah.
And Jeff came up.
Because he's a fiddler.
And Jeff says, okay, my name is Jeff. Would you like to play in my concert? I said,
really?
Oh, lovely.
Really?
So that's how I came to Wolfton.
Yeah.
And after I played a few concerts here, so made myself a little popular here. So afterward, and I went to Norway for 10 years, Japan for 20 years.
Yeah.
And this year is a 30 years anniversary. So I want to come back to say hello to Jeff. So I just came to the art center, asked Jeff, and found him.
Wow.
Very lucky after 30 years.
Yes.
And very happy. And the first person Jeff introduced me is Alistair.
Oh, really?
Yes. So we came here right the same day.
Oh,
and I was fascinated by his work.
Yeah.
That's why I come here quite a few times. This is the third time I come here.
Wow.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
I hope to make a good video to introduce him to the world.
Yeah, that would be great.
I have my own video YouTube channel.
Yes.
So I have every 28 days, I have like 2 to 3 million viewers.
You hear
that?
Yes.
That is fantastic.
That's huge.
Yeah. So I did not know that I can get so popular.
Wow.
It's so natural. I only film natural things.
Yeah.
No, nothing is placed, nothing is you know planned or staged.
Yeah.
Everything happening in the real life, so people love that.
That's great.
So, and also I heard that Alistair, he does for the island.
Oh, yes. Vanuatu.
So that's something I would really like to follow him.
Yes. Yeah, he's done a lot of work.
Not only art, but also as a person, as his heart. So he trying to help people to get more people appreciate art.
Because of a family connection, like with his family, and it's nice to have that connection with his parents that were over there and going over there.
Yes,
and
his grandmother lived in China for 20 years.
Yes.
And his mother was born in China.
Yeah.
So all those things have very, and also he has a Japanese wife.
Yes. Mm. Yeah.
So all have something to do linking with my life experience.
Yeah. Yeah. It's nice how everything kind of
I was born in China.
Yes.
And I've been living in Japan for 20 years.
Yeah.
I could speak Japanese to his wife.
Yes.
So it's nice. Anyway, this time comes back to Melbourne, to Walkton.
Oh, that's really great.
Very nice. Very
I wish
good
I'd
experience.
Had a nicer t-shirt on.
Okay,
I've got my grotty old t-shirt.
Well,
I'll
go to Vanuatu next year and get a nice t-shirt there.
Yes.
All this thanks to you, teacher. Yes. Okay, that's
so
great.
Cool.
Well, we're having a cup of tea. So.
Yes, okay.
This is Malakuma.
Mm-hmm.
And the place that I go to is way down south. I get pencil, it's easier to show. Malakula, Southwest Bay is just in here.
Mm-hmm.
And if it'll let us see, if it adjusts, it may give us a name of a village.
Mm.
You see, it's becoming bigger. Now that looks as though it's a lake, but it's not. It's actually a lagoon and it's open to the sea. But this whole area, there at Wintua.
Mm-hmm.
Wintua is where the plain lands,
mm-hmm.
and it doesn't show you very much up here, but the village that I go to, there's another guest house. That's probably one of the other guest houses that you can stay at.
Mm-hmm.
The village I go to is just here.
Mm-hmm.
So if you walk from Wintua, it's a good hour. But
mm-hmm.
if you catch a boat, it's only 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So usually you catch a boat up to the village.
Mm-hmm.
And this is actually open to the sea.
Mm-hmm.
And there's also bungalows in here that
mm-hmm.
you can stay.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a village in here.
Mm-hmm.
There's another village right here.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a village on the corner. There's quite a few villages. You could do some beautiful walking
mm-hmm.
in this area.
Mm-hmm.
But this is a very protected bay.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of yachts come and stop here.
Mm-hmm.
To keep away from the storms and to have safe place to stop. So very popular with yachties from around the world.
Mm.
But it's quite a big island, as you can see.
I want to see the peak or location. Where is the Australia?
Right, well, we come back. If you go that way, about 1,000 kilometres, you hit Cairns. So if we pull out, we keep pulling out, and you'll soon see Australia. So here's Australia, there's Sydney.
Mm-hmm.
And Brisbane, Cairns is up here,
mm-hmm.
and there's Vanuatu. So it's about the same. And there's the Coral Sea.
Okay.
There's the Solomon Islands,
mm-hmm.
New Caledonia, and it's out here. Fiji's way out here.
Okay, I understand.
Okay.
So I can go from Malaysia, I think.
You can probably go from Malaysia.
Yeah, okay.
The other place you can go from, which is good too, is New Zealand.
Mm-hmm.
You can fly and do something in New Zealand and then go to Vanuatu,
mm-hmm.
or you can fly to Brisbane or Cairns
mm-hmm.
and get a flight out from Brisbane
mm-hmm.
or Cairns. You can fly.
Okay.
There's an airport in Luganville
mm-hmm.
in Santo. That's here. That's Luganville. This is the biggest island. That's
mm-hmm.
Santo. You can fly into Santo. Into Luganville, and then from there you can get a flight down to Southwest Bay.
Okay, how much normally cost a flight? Round trip.
Return trip to
mm-hmm.
Vanuatu,
mm-hmm.
About $650.
Oh, that's
from
not,
Australia,
that's
not so
not
bad.
Much.
But then you've got to add on about $250 return from Port Vila or
mm-hmm.
somewhere,
oh, okay.
just to get to the island. So,
mm.
yeah, under $1,000 you
oh,
can
okay.
do it.
Yeah.
Not
mm.
so bad.
Mm. Good, nice. Okay, looking forward.
These are
okay.
slightly not
thank you so
Australian
much. Thank you.
Oh, what have you done
on the
outside?
Just on the inside. Oh, yeah, we went into
by
the
accident.
The water wheel and had a look.
You tell me you're
going to
start with the
pregnant.
You guys
mm.
think this doesn't fit me.
Thank
you.
No worries. Well, Alex found a
point
really
good.
Okay,
thanks
for
the tea.
No worries. Thank you.
Okay.
I'm trying to get one, so I haven't.
Okay.
Earlier.
Nice seeing all of you.
Nice
yeah.
to meet you.
And I will follow you to the island once. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
See you
nice
again.
Nice to meet you.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Nice to meet you.